Hello everyone, this is Luanne Maureen and welcome to Answering the Call of Your Purpose podcast. I'm very excited to have you here and welcome our beautiful guest, Gigi Lindros. Hello, Gigi.
Hello.
Beautiful. So before we jump in, and I'm going to ask you all these questions about your purpose and how you answered it, Gigi, I just want to do a really quick reminder for those who are new to this podcast, what this is all about. And what I've found working with spiritual entrepreneurs, there's always something that they have, you know, done to find their purpose. And so this is a reason why I want to interview and people like you, Gigi, is to know, well, what is your purpose and how did you create your business from that, you know, if that's something that you've done. So this is what this is all about. And I always choose my guests very wisely because they inspire me as well. So Gigi, welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
So we're just going to go right in here. So what do you do right now in your work, in your business, and what led you here today?
Okay. So I am a web designer extraordinaire, which means that I not only create websites, landing pages, and courses, I also support with strategizing your business so it works with a beautiful flow and is automated. So there is no more overwhelm or no more waste of time for you.
Yeah. And you did mine. So everybody, yes. She is the extraordinaire. Go to my website and go to her website. We'll put all the links below, ggm.com. I'm just going to put that there. But what led you to that, Gigi? Because I know there's a whole backstory that led you to this piece and you know, how are you implementing your purpose in it?
Yes, what led me here? I think it's my curiosity. One of my foundation, it's like the drive of me is curiosity. So, I just always go with that kind of flow. And then also I like... when I try something and if it doesn't work, I move on to the next thing, which has been quite challenging because it felt like I never could stop anywhere and really dig deep into it before I moved on to the next thing. What led me to what I'm actually doing now as my business is that I like technology and I like design and I like communities. I've been in your community for many years. And I started doing on Wix, I started doing websites. One was for Viking Feast, the other one was for a cafe out in a bed and breakfast, so many different things. And I never published them, but they were like my vision boards. And that way I learned the technology because I really love to see the colors, to see the fonts, put all my ideas into one place and strategize them. Mm-hmm. So they all look, oh, that will work in that area there and that will work. That's how it started. And then I remember it was one of your events. We were like, okay, did a Persephone or something.
Yes.
Yes,
the Persephone program. That's right. It's all perfect. Yeah.
And yes. Like, and I remember this is years ago. And I remember I said to you, like, it feels like I'm living my purpose and I don't know what it is. I remember it so vividly. It was like a weird feeling. It was like I was in the middle of my own purpose and I had no idea what it was. And I can't remember your answer on that, but I think you said something with design and then it's like, oh, okay. I still didn't connect it with what I'm, that's how it started. And that's how I got into it. And then on top of that, I read my hands, you did my hands, you read my hands. And then it was another step into the right direction, the flavor of it's like, oh, I'm on the right track. So then my purpose is family and community. Yes. And I knew that because I love to create little evenings with 600 candles from IKEA. So I did that. I created food and I made this like cozy atmosphere for people to come and listen to my stories. Because I got so many things on my string on my bow, so it's unbelievable. So I need to kind of whoop. But that's how it started. And And then I felt this community. I love the community and just listen to people. And I wanted to incorporate all of that into one business. That was my drive, also my curiosity to see if I could use everything that I learned, be about trying so many different things in my life, see how much of that I could bring into one business.
Wow.
So that's how it, so some of it, sometimes like some of it that I've learned during the years are coming in now.
Yes. Even,
yeah. And it's still, I know I haven't fit where I am today. Is not where I'm going to stay. I'm going to keep on going with the web design and everything, strategizing and support and business and all that, and go into further and further and further. So it's no end station there. It's like, keep on going with it. Yeah.
Well, that's what I kind of say, you know, well, it was like, what do you believe your purpose is? But you just told me it's family and community.
Yes.
And in our business, we have the choice to express it through that. But like I always say, business is not your purpose. It's an expression of that. So,
yeah.
And it sounds to me like you've expressed it in all different types. Like I remember coming to your Viking night.
Yes.
Right? What an amazing community of, well, let's tell people where you're from if they haven't guessed already.
Yeah, if they haven't guessed, my name, I'm Swedish.
Yes, and I just love that heritage that you have, because it's very similar to the Maori heritage, but totally different but similar, you know, that warrior type.
Yeah, it's the tribe.
Yeah, the tribe, the community. Mm. And now you're doing it in this flavor. And yeah, I just always, even time I'm in your presence or I see you, even online, it's like you really care about this community. You know, you're growing the tribe and inspirational. Yeah, beautiful.
Yeah.
So how did you answer the call of your purpose?
What does that mean?
So what that means is like I read your hands,
yes,
right? Mm. Because knowing your purpose is not answering it. And sometimes we get a little nudge on our shoulder or it's like, I'm really going to step into that now.
Mm. Yes. I think it was after, you know, you have, when I'm slightly older than you, but you know where your life is like divided into different lives.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, that was like a different lifetime. So you feel like you lived maybe three lives when you come into my age, and then you probably live a fourth if you're lucky living that long. But I just, when the kids grew up and we moved back to Melbourne at the time, and kids started school, they started school, and I was sitting there, what shall I do? And I'm a travel agent, business travel agent. And
so
I did
many
what,
things.
Wow. Yeah, I know. Yeah, and I had a sushi restaurant. Yeah. It's like crazy, crazy different things.
Right.
But so I said that I didn't want to go back to the travel agent work. So I thought, well, what shall I do? I need to do something. I had that desire within myself to create something for myself. And I wanted to create success. I wanted to be successful. What that meant to me is different for everybody. But I just wanted something that worked, that I felt proud of, that generated an income, obviously, and hopefully like more income than I put my work into it, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't get exhausted. But so that the kids went to school, and I had that desire inside of doing something. And then I started the search, and that's when we connected. And it took 10 years for me to move into it. And so it was a desire within myself.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I think the trigger was that the kids started school. Like my immediate attention to the kids went out the door to school, and then I had that space of creating something for myself. And now even now they're 18 and 16, now I have even more time to kind of dig even deeper into my purpose or my joy.
Yeah.
Wow. So I wanted to create something with joy.
I love that. So you answered it with just, and I mean, that's actually really interesting saying it was over 10 years, but you tried different things. And I was kind of the same, you know, we did Goddess. And you, I think you were actually one of the very first people that came to one of my Goddess evenings way back 12 years ago or something. And I remember you. Now, is it very Swedish to bring flowers?
Yeah, you always bring a gift.
Right. Yeah, yeah. And I didn't even know you. You came with another person and you bought me these flowers. And I went, oh, my goodness. Nobody else bought me flowers, just you. But again, yeah, that led me to where I am now, and we're, and the same for you. And yes, you already said it. There's going to be another phase.
I know that, and it's exciting. So we never, as business owners, as you know, we never stand still, or we shouldn't stand still. It's not normal. So you have to just keep on going and growing and being uncomfortable in that, and you know, but it's also exciting because it's like, I wonder what I can do if I try this.
Yeah.
And if it doesn't work, drop it, do something else, you know.
I think the sad thing is when people don't try, they'll never know.
Yeah.
Like, at least we know. Yeah. Well, that didn't work. Let's try something else. Or, that did work. Wow.
Yeah.
So why do you think, Gigi, it's important to do your purpose work?
It is kind of everything. I just want to feel I live my full potential.
Yeah.
Not just, take the just word out. I want to live my life's potential. And the life potential is in many ways. It's not only my business, but I just want to in that area too. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure. That's the only answer.
Yep. Perfect. Yep. So knowing your purpose is one thing, right? You had your hand read, or you just knew it, you know, how it
was. I kind of knew, but I didn't know what it was. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, you're already in it.
Yeah.
But what else do you think it takes to actually step into that or embody that and live that? Like sometimes, I mean, we had our beautiful friend Kathy, and she talked about, well, knowing my purpose, but then I need to know my values. Or somebody else said, I know my purpose, but I need to do shadow work to bring that up. What's one of your practices or modalities, not that you have to do, or that that's helped support you?
Yeah, it is actually. What really helps me is my morning routine.
Oh.
And I try to think positive thoughts just before I fall asleep.
Wow.
So when I wake up, I hopefully have, unless I had a really bad dream, then that follows you for a while. But it's the morning routine, and that is, I get up and I do 20 minutes yoga, and then I have tea or lemon water, and then I take my dog for a walk, and just really mindful of where I look. Well, I look at the trees. We live in a suburb, so I walk around, but I look at the trees. I try to look at the flowers. And then when I get home, it can vary because I don't like to do the same things all the time. So sometimes it can be something I can do, breathing exercise, or one morning I don't do it, but it is the morning routines that keeps me sane. But then also the other thing is to be brave and try to get out of my head, trying to think my way into how this is going to work and who is going to like it. And who is going to buy it? It never works that way. You just have to do it and do and don't be perfect. It's just, I have that in my mind all the time. Doesn't need to be perfect. And I'm going to look back at that in 2 years' time, and I'm going to laugh my head off that I even put that out. But it made me, you know, go to the next step and see what works with people and connect with people.
I love that. And the morning, I kind of struggle with the morning routine. Like, not envious. I really honor you for doing that. Some days I'm like, I'll do 3 days in a row. I've got my journal, have my little, cup of tea, and just write my thoughts. But when you say it with such conviction, it's like, I do this. And it's kind of the routine, even though sometimes we don't like doing the same thing. It's like you change it up too.
Yeah, it can be shaking. I'll just shake and dance to
something.
And it doesn't matter. It's moving the body and kind of get your energy back into your gut or your womb. You just need to get it all back in.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite questions, knowing all the what you all do, you know. It's like Gigi shakes. It's really helpful and helpful for people who watch and listen as well.
And obviously there are lots of other things. It can go for healings and tapping and all sorts of things, like on top of that. But something I try to, like a routine I do every day, except Saturdays and Sundays. I'm not very good with, I want to lay in on
Is it the 20-80-20 rule? You know, 80% of the time,
yes.
It's great, right?
Yes.
You have the rest 20. So then I want to ask you, Gigi, who has been one of your favorite people that you've worked with in your business and why?
Right. Yes, I wonder who that can be. No, one of my favorite people is actually you. And it is the I like fire horse, I like action takers.
Yeah.
And I actually really enjoy seeing you galloping around like a mad horse,
a mad person.
And then I can just pull in a little bit. She doesn't gallop around madly. But I like the way you want to, yeah, just go. And then it's easier for me. It's probably easier for a lot of business owners. Instead of pushing people to do something, you can pull it back a little bit. Within your energy, obviously, so you don't feel like contained and like in prison, but like a little bit. Maybe we should can just go that way a little bit, and then yeah, I like that. So that's my favorite.
Yeah.
You're my like ideal client, and you also got a strong desire to create something that is on purpose and that is meaningful for everybody. Or for your tribe, and in general for the whole world. I really like that. I think that makes my purpose even stronger, because it makes sense. If I can make you be seen online, then to help you in your purpose, that's a proper purpose, if you know what I mean.
And I know you've got some other, a lot of your clients are like me, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So I guess there can be the other side of that where people are not just, they just really struggle to give you staff, and then that's your job. So I love that analogy of like, oh, we'll just go, just
and it's not like that. It's like,
nudge, you know.
Yeah.
But that's the thing, like we can trust, it's me trusting you. And one thing that I totally do, and it's like you'll come back to, oh, how about we just tweak this? I'm like, oh yeah, you know, like for me, I had to let total control go. And you know, when I'm controlling, I'm like, she's like, and I can see you rolling your eyes on the other side, but I'm like, you're just letting me vent. And then it's like, and then you go boom, and I'm like, wow, you know. So
yeah,
great synergy and who you
want to work with. And obviously sometimes it can be quite nice to have other clients that are a little bit more careful. They're willing, but they're a bit more careful. So you have to kind of guide them a little bit, and nurture them. And that is also really nice clients to work with, obviously. Yeah.
You can't have too many. Well, it's a beautiful balance.
Yes, it is. It's a balance. And I'm Libra, so I like the balance. So I can't just have fire horse, I call you fire horse, or the action. Yeah, you could if you're really structured. Yeah.
Yeah.
I like the nurturing as well. We can nurture fire horses too.
You do. So I wanted to where can we find you? Like, where can we find you online?
You can find me on gigigem.com.
Beautiful. And you've got a Facebook group too. Is that invite only, or can people come and just join you?
Yeah, you can join me. So that's Business Gems.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gem. So you are a gem, Gigi.
Yeah, I'm a business gem. But the funny thing, people think it is just made up, but it is my three letters in my name.
Yes.
Yonelele and Mariam. So it makes sense. And Gigi is my nickname before no one could say my real name. So Gigi is my nickname, and Gem is actually my real name, like the first letters.
Wow. I love that.
Yeah.
And so what would you, before I ask you my ending question, it just goes so fast. What would your advice be to somebody, you know, really thinking about their purpose and, you know, searching for it? What would your advice be to somebody?
What would I advise? Keep on going, never stop, and really tune in to slow down, never stop looking for your purpose, but slow down so you can hear your purpose. You can hear the voice and then fall, like just fall into it and just follow that as much as you can, even if it's scary sometimes. You can change a lot of things in families and like just lean into it and follow that. And then obviously, I mean, the hand readings that you've done, that really helps as well. You're not going to tell people what's going to happen in 2022. It's not about that, but it's such a strong foundation of who you are. I mean, when I look at what you said about my hands, I can really connect with that.
Yeah.
So doing that as well, I would actually absolutely recommend this as well to look at your hands, because you get your purpose, you get your, I know this is not about hand reading, but yeah. I think it really helps to get you a little bit. So it's a confirmation more than anything that you're on the right track, that what you're feeling is correct.
Yes.
And then you have to explore it.
Yeah, you know, right? Well, you kind of know, but there's that trepidation. It's like, oh, is it really right? And then it's there. And what I love too, G, is you use this for your own clients, right?
Yeah, yeah. And that's the thing. You can use it in your business. It makes it that unique selling point. That you can add to your business. And you can kind of add hand and I have that word. Is
analysis. So I know.
Analysis. I can never say it. But that is so, you can add it to nearly any business, to be honest.
Pretty much, yeah.
Pretty much.
We're similar actually, but you can.
You can, to teams. You know, if you're working with teams, I mean, seriously, there's so many, yeah.
Yeah.
So I would do that. But first of all, I would just not stop looking and then listen to yourself and really have the guts to nurture yourself and do what you feel like you want to do. And I think we get better with that after 50, because you kind of can't be bothered with what people think or say anymore, you know.
Oh, yeah. That is so true. I often think, you know, you see somebody in their 30s, even 40s, now I'm like, oh, thank goodness that's done, you know. It's a different, but not even to say, oh, you know, we all go through it. But then also a lot of the people or the kids, they're growing up a lot quicker, and they're more wisdom than when I was a kid, you know. That there's something which the world needs, as
yes.
All right, my love, well, this has been amazing. So could you end on telling us something that no one knows about you? Well, your husband might know about you, or
yes, yes, I think a few people know about, just a few people, but I actually met Duke of Edinburgh, which is the father or the husband to the Queen of England and father to Charles and Andrew. And there, not a lot of people know about it, but I was at a pair in Windsor and we were out jogging in Windsor. I don't jog. So that is amazing. That's something you don't know about me. I don't jog. But I was jogging. I was young. I was 19. And it's a long park, it's 1 kilometer. So you can jog there. And we were just jogging along. My au pair mom and her friend was a little bit ahead of me. And I see this carriage come out with two men on there and two horses. So just, oh, your horses look lovely. Oh, thank you. So he stopped and he's chatting to me for a while. I can't remember what he talked to me about, but he was like, oh, you out jogging, just like normal stuff. Wow. And the mom and her friend is just standing like 10 meters away like this.
You just
said I had no idea. So, and then I would red, my cheeks were red because I get red when I jog. I came up to my mom, the au pair mom, and she said, Gigi, do you know who you were speaking to? And I went, no. Oh, that was Duke of Edinburgh. And I went, who's that?
Yeah.
I had no idea. I didn't even know who that was. So she said, you spoke to the Queen's husband. And I went, you're kidding. I couldn't get in contact with Andrew, because Andrew was like, he was really nice looking at the time.
Oh, right. Well, he's in the bad books now.
He's the bad books now.
The bad man.
Yes. But it was like, oh, no.
I missed
the opportunity. But I'm glad I did.
Lisa wasn't a child. Mm, oh my goodness, that's hilarious.
Yeah, it's hilarious.
I can just imagine, just a normal person, you know, just a normal person.
No, really. He looked like he was actually taking care of the horses. That's the thing. I'm a girl from the north of Sweden who had no, like, I was only 19. I had no idea I knew who the queen was. I could recognize her. But
you didn't know her husband. No. And a girl from 19, you're blind. Yeah. I just running around. Yeah, I love it.
He was funny.
Oh, yes. Well, thank you so much, Gigi, for having this interview, answering the call of your purpose. Love you so much. And again, everyone, if you're listening and watching, go and check her out at ggem.com. Yes. And there's some great options there for you if you're looking, for website or strategy and all that. And so thank you so much, Gigi. Okay.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.